Just 4 years after the end of World War II, Swedish engineers at Saab unveiled a radical design for the ultimate European warplane, the Saab 35 Draken. This fighter interceptor was light years ahead of its era, engineered to chase down Soviet bombers at dizzying altitudes and blistering speeds, guarding its homeland from the threat of nuclear devastation. With scant precedents for such an audacious design, it took Sweden over 15 years to perfect the bold double delta wing configuration, marked by its cutting-edge, aggressive profile and top-of-the-line technology. Once operational, the Draken ascended as an unstoppable force, becoming the only European warbird to shatter the Mach 2 barrier. However, the aircraft's most notable attribute, its double delta wing configuration, also proved to be its Achilles heel, rendering the jet unstable and prone to sudden losses of control during critical phases of flight. Test pilots often encountered uncontrollable stalls when pushing the aircraft to high angles of attack. In response, they developed a groundbreaking technique, the cobra maneuver. By quickly reducing the angle of attack, they transformed the airframe into an impromptu air brake, radically impacting aerial maneuverability. Yet whether this bold maneuver could neutralize the risks tied to its ambitious and novel wing configuration, or if this futuristic Swedish warplane was destined to falter from the get-go, remained in the air. Designed to succeed the Saab J-29 Tonnen and the fighter variant of the Saab 32 Lansen, the Draken was introduced when high-altitude bombers like the American B-36 and the Soviet Tu-95 posed a significant threat. These enemy bombers could soar above 30,000 feet, far out of reach of the era's anti-aircraft guns, and were capable of delivering nuclear payloads. Amidst the Cold War, with superpowers enhancing their strategic bomber fleets capable of nuclear strikes, Sweden's strategic location between the Western and Eastern blocs exposed it to immense risk. Its airspace, a potential corridor for bombers targeting either side, placed Sweden's sovereignty and security on the front line of nuclear jeopardy. The advent of these high-flying threats, potentially evading early radar detection systems, still in their nascent stages, spurred Sweden into action. Recognizing the stakes, Sweden kickstarted a robust defense initiative focusing on air superiority. This included developing advanced interceptors like the Saab 35 Draken and enhancing radar capabilities. Moreover, Sweden fortified its defense infrastructure with extensive underground facilities and air bases, shielding its Air Force assets from aerial assaults. The Draken and Tonnen became integral to Sweden's innovative BAS 60 strategy, a defense plan devised to scatter and camouflage military aircraft across various makeshift bases countrywide. By leveraging natural landscapes and existing infrastructures like roads and highways, this strategy aimed to sustain operational effectiveness in the event of an attack. With the shadow of nuclear-capable bombers always present, the urgency for a comprehensive air defense system and an equally capable warplane was paramount to deter airspace violations and preserve Sweden's cherished neutrality amidst escalating global tensions. Thus, Saab engineers crafted the Draken, an advanced and powerful interceptor that promised to defend Sweden's skies without relying on superpower alliances. Yet crafting the ultimate European warplane domestically was a daunting task. The saga of the Swedish Draken interceptor began in the fall of 1949, when the Swedish Air Force, guided by the Defense Materiel Administration, laid down a fresh set of demands for a cutting-edge interceptor. A paramount requirement was the ability to engage enemy bombers at transonic speeds, setting a blistering minimum top speed of Mach 1.4. By 1956, this speed requirement was escalated to Mach 1.7, and just 3 years later pushed even further to a lightning-fast Mach 2.0. The design also called for a cockpit tailored for a single pilot to command the aircraft in all weather conditions, day or night, and from the most rugged airstrips while bristling with the firepower needed to take down modern jet bombers. In addition to its impressive combat specs, the aircraft was designed with practicality in mind. It had to be straightforward enough for conscripts with minimal training to refuel and rearm within a mere 10 minutes. Unlike its contemporary, the American Air Force F-104 starfighters, the Draken was tailored uniquely for Swedish defense strategies, including operating from reinforced public roads, a tactic developed during the Cold War as part of the BAS-60 and eventually BAS-90 plans. Designed to endure the demanding Scandinavian climates, the Draken was built to last, featuring a robust Swedish version of the Rolls-Royce Avon engine and innovative elements like the twin-wheel tail scraper, crafted to prevent tail strikes during aggressive takeoff and landing maneuvers. This aircraft was an extension of Swedish ingenuity and philosophy, designed to command the skies and maintain Sweden's sovereignty with unmatched capability and resilience. Meeting the ambitious specifications for the advanced interceptor aircraft posed a daunting challenge for the engineers and designers. Initial studies indicated a delta wing configuration could solve several critical design issues. With its distinctive triangular shape, the delta wing offered substantial advantages such as increased internal volume for fuel storage and structural robustness. However, this design also introduced higher aerodynamic drag, demanding a creative solution to balance the aircraft's performance needs. The designers initially extended the forward fuselage to optimize aerodynamics further, but this adjustment led to an excessively heavy aircraft. In a bold move, they pivoted to a pioneering approach, the double delta wing configuration. This design was entirely untested, and in an era before the convenience of computer simulations and digital wind tunnels, the engineers embarked on a meticulous and grueling journey. Extensive wind tunnel testing was crucial to understanding the double delta's behavior, as mock-ups alone couldn't capture the full dynamics of flight. This unprecedented configuration and the grueling trial-and-error approach prolonged the development progress of the Draken, as one obstacle after another surfaced with most prototype trails. Driven by the need for empirical data, a dedicated team of over 500 technicians led by aviation engineer Eric Bratt constructed a scaled-down but fully operational test aircraft, the Saab 210, affectionately dubbed Lil Draken or Little Dragon. This mini prototype first took to the skies above Stockholm in January 1952, delivering an impressive performance that paved the way for further development. Encouraged by the success of the Lil Draken, the team greenlit the construction of 3 full-size prototypes. In a moment that marked a significant milestone in Swedish aviation history, the first full-scale Draken roared into the sky 3 years later, proving the worth of its revolutionary design and solidifying the path forward for Sweden's air defense capabilities. This design not only provided outstanding aerodynamic efficiency, but also delivered exceptional takeoff and landing performance essential for operating from both conventional runways and makeshift road bases. The first prototype of the Draken, despite lacking an afterburner, successfully soared on its maiden flight. Flight International magazine highlighted that an intensive flight test program was essential to fully unveil the aircraft's blistering speed, expansive range, and intricate systems. In a stunning development, the second prototype, this time equipped with an afterburner, accidentally broke the sound barrier during its initial ascent, marking a significant milestone and demonstrating that the potential of the Draken was barely beginning to be understood. The Draken's double delta wing configuration was not just functional, it proved exceptionally effective. Yet this design also introduced an inherent instability that could turn deadly. As pilots faced perilous stalls at high angles of attack, they had to think on their feet, manipulating the warplane's design to their advantage by swiftly reducing the angle of attack, effectively turning the airframe into its own air brake to slash speed in an instant. Swedish Saab dubbed this maneuver the court parade, or cobra maneuver. The Draken's unique wing configuration allowed it to execute this abrupt pitch-up, initially a tactic to counteract the aircraft's propensity for super stalls stemming from its tailless design. While this instability posed a challenge in the early days, it later enabled the rapid pitch changes that defined the Cobra maneuver. This technique demonstrated the Saab 35's extraordinary agility to the world, boasting twice the maneuverability of other single-engine jets of its time. It eliminated the need for a traditional tailplane, embracing a sleek, streamlined profile instead. While the Cobra maneuver wasn't initially designed for combat, Draken pilots set the stage for similar combat tactics that allow aviators to sharply decelerate and force a trailing fighter to overshoot, providing a crucial tactical edge in dogfights. Deliveries of Draken's inaugural model kicked off in late 1959. As Flight International reported, the integration of the J-35A into service was not just smooth, but also quick, with scramble and turnaround times described as, quote, most satisfactory. The first Swedish Air Force wing to be outfitted with the Draken was F-13, stationed at Norrköping. By the end of 1960, multiple wings had not only received the Draken, but had also reached operational status. While the J-35 Draken was initially designed as a high-altitude interceptor rather than a dogfighter, it excelled in both capacities, showcasing robust quick-turn capabilities and maintaining high speeds across various altitudes. Initially created solely for air defense, the enhanced J-35B model soon followed. This version boasted a beefed-up power plant, the license-built Rolls-Royce Avon 200/300 engine, or Svenska Flygmotor RM6B/C, an enlarged afterburner, and a redesigned rear fuselage. It also featured a new Saab-built S7 collision course gunsight and fire control radar, integrated seamlessly with the Air Defense Control Network STRIL-60. In total, 651 Drakens were manufactured, spanning six different versions within the Swedish fleet. Additionally, two export models were introduced, primarily to Denmark and Finland. These variants came equipped with a Ferranti-built AirPass 2 fire control radar, adept at acquiring a variety of air-to-air or air-to-surface targets, and enhancing navigational systems through ground mapping mode. The Saab 35 found as much success abroad as it did at home. The United States acquired a dozen formerly Danish Drakens for training purposes, while Austria purchased several dozen specially refurbished J-35Ds, outfitting them with internal cannons instead of air-to-air missiles due to restrictions imposed by the Austrian State Treaty. Primarily, the cockpit of the Draken was decked out with Swedish-sourced instrumentation, but newer models ramped up the tech with upgrades like a revamped canopy and cutting-edge avionics, including a three-axis autopilot. The typical setup featured dual radio units, a high-speed data link, and a pair of navigation systems. However, the joystick lacked natural feedback, so a Q-feel system was introduced to generate artificial forces, mimicking the traditional tactile feedback pilots rely on. The Draken's structure was split into a front and rear section, bolted together for robustness. The front section housed the fire control radar, cockpit, nose undercarriage, integral fuel tanks, and other essential systems integrated with the intake ducts and wing. Meanwhile, the rear section was a single unit with the inner wing, containing the powerhouse engine and afterburner, bag-type fuel tanks, main landing gear, a drogue parachute for deceleration, and the aircraft's primary armament. The operational Draken boasted a maximum operational ceiling of approximately 66,000 feet, allowing it to perform high-altitude intercepts under any weather condition. It could easily reach a maximum speed of Mach 2, roughly twice the speed of sound. Its dimensions included a length of 15.35 meters and a wingspan of 9.42 meters, making it a sizable warplane. Still, it required just 800 meters to become airborne, and a similar distance to land, thanks to its powerful afterburner and robust landing gear. Regarding firepower, the Draken's primary armament included up to four AIM-9 Sidewinder air-to-air missiles mounted on hardpoints under the wings and fuselage. Alternatively, the payload could vary from a selection of bombs and rockets to a pair of 30mm cannons embedded in each inboard wing panel, or additional fuel tanks could occupy these slots for extended range. The J-35 could be equipped with various camera pods slung underneath the fuselage for reconnaissance missions, adapting to intelligence gathering requirements. Over the decades, the Draken saw several iterations, with the J-35J being the final upgrade in the late 1980s. By then, however, the Saab 37 Viggen had already replaced the Draken, leading to its phase-out by 1999. The Draken left an indelible mark with its innovative double-delta configuration and the implementation of the Cobra maneuver, which gained traction at Saab. Remarkably, This aircraft continued to serve in some capacity until the mid-2000s through a service life extension program, rounding out an impressive five-decade tenure for what began as an experimental design.